tell your Lakeside community. What I'd like to say is, I mentioned on there were a couple occasions where someone got rents for $250 off, utilities included, and $350 off, utilities included. But those are far and few between. Those were done through word of mouth, and I'm not going to say there's a lot of them. So if you're going to run down to IE hoping you're going to get one, I don't know. There's some hotels I put on a video. There's a couple hotels. One of them was, I was talking with the gentleman there, and it's on video. They're on video. They're not on the camera, but you can hear them in the background. Just a couple blocks from to the plaza on the Kittatinna Highway, there's a hotel, and a gentleman said they were paying, I think he was paying 6,000 pesos, which is equivalent to $300 a month. But those you got in those other apartments, they're word of mouth, or you got to go and check. But I want to talk about the city of Chapala, and you can get a better chance you're going to get a more affordable rental, and you're going to be able to live less expensively in Chapala, the city of beautiful city of Chapala, for a lot less money or less money than you will in chances. Now, I'm going to tell you, there's some big homes and some big rentals in Chapala. Very expensive ones. Very beautiful, elegant, grand places. And also in San Nicolas de Ibarra. One of the recent videos I put up, well, that was quite expensive. But you can find beautiful rentals. And you can find, there's some very elegant ones. Donaway and Ahihi, San Antonio, San Juan Cosa, Hakota Pack, Ramirez del Pilar, and even in Chapala, you can find some pretty nice homes. But for those who don't want to buy a home, or those who want lower rents or can't afford, I would really suggest trying Chapala. Try Chapala out and do some research, and some of you already know this, but Chapala is a beautiful place. Who knows? You know, I can even wind up in Chapala. I mean, I can afford to live in Ahihi, in a nice place, and even in a bigger place than I'm at now. But Chapala is, I know a lot of people who live happily in Chapala, and they get good rents, and they get big places. Huge places, talking about couples, and then you get single people move into nice size homes or apartments there. So Chapala is one place you probably want to check out as well. Whether you have a lower social security, whether you are on a mid-range social security, whether you're on you want to look or find something big, you can afford that. But Chapala is a very affordable place. There's been places for $300 that I've known. I helped the guy out. You can hear more about that in a previous video that I'm uploading now. And hopefully it'll get uploaded by tomorrow. Hopefully, because it's a rather long video, but it's got a lot of valuable information, so look at that, and keep an open mind to Chapala, and talk to people who actually live in Chapala, because they'll tell you, a lot of people will say, it's a great place to live. So also consider doing research, and as I mentioned, I even talked with someone who lives in El Chante, beautiful, big home there. She lives alone, and occasionally she has a friend come down and stay there, and she's got a good rental price there. So San Juan Cosa, check out there, check out Hakota Peck, check out Ramirez del Pilar. Even he has some really good places that are affordable, and then also but you know, the surrounding communities, San Antonio, Chapala, City of Chapala, those places are really, you know, places you can look out to live however you want and go from there. So with that, this is a short video. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, look at the channel description that I put up. I put up some newer information, and you'll find out more about this channel and some other things. So please, you know, keep viewing, and thanks for viewing today, and good luck finding rentals. And if you see me in town, like other people have, please ask me questions, and I'll be happy to help you. I'll spend some time and happy to help you with certain things. You know, I'm not long term. I've only been coming back to Puerto Mexico for 4 years. I probably spent an actual full 2 years in Mexico, and I'm in my second snowbird season because I've been to cities like Cuernavaca, Oaxaca City, Guadalajara a little bit, Tlaquepaque, all these places. But I've been coming. This is my second snowbird season in Ajijic, so I do know some things about Ajijic, a little bit about San Miguel de Allende, but more so about Ajijic and this lakeside area. So in the whole lakeside area. So please stop me, as like other people do, and I'll be happy to help you. Have a great day, and thanks for viewing.